waiting on back orders again? Your neighbor isn't. He ordered from NPD. National Parts Depot continues to be the nation's leading source for quality restoration parts and supplies for Ford, truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. With four strategically located superstores, you'll find everything you need shipped to your door within 1 to 3 business days. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll-free. Don't let back orders stall your project. NPD takes the frustration out of restoration.
We're basically in the stock position for the other side of the car, but we're going to move our mount position a little further forward. And the reason for that is our surround is really tight on the driver's side. Now we can fudge that a little bit in the future, but on this side we want to get it right. So we're going to move it forward and out just a little bit more to make sure this thing's going to fit. And after we get this basically eyeballed in, we're going to put our trim panel in and do some measurements again and bore ourselves to death doing this over and over and over and over and over. We got our trim panel. We're just going to set that up here for right now. I'm not going to be banging a hammer on anything. And what we're going to do is mark our position on the floor. What I like to do is mark the outside perimeter along with the center of the hull, just to kind of give myself a relative position. Because if you just do the center of the hull, guess what? You don't know what the angle needs to be whenever you set everything up for final. This way you kind of have a general idea. Here comes our first snag of the day on the trim panel. Now, we're not sure how this happened, but quite frankly, the gap is about 2 fingers wide. So the mount position for the trim panel is in the wrong spot. So we're going to have to cut that out and remount it in the correct position so that our trim panel sits where it's supposed to, because right now, there ain't no way that trim panel's gonna bolt up. So, fun. Time to get the cutter! Alright, what we've had to do is we've had to cut this mount position for the trim panel off. There's a line on the fastbacks. It's actually a crease in the panel, and I'm pretty sure that's where this is supposed to align to. It would have been a point that the assembly line worker would have had, so we had a way to know where to mount this. These welds that are on here are not spot welds, which tells me that this bracket was moved post-production, meaning that somebody somewhere got in here with a welder and acted like a monkey. So, we're going to fix their work. But we're not going to weld this in right now. We're going to actually set the trim panel so that we can make sure this is in the correct position, and then we'll weld later on. We may even have to move that one in the back, although I don't think it's been messed with. But so far I've been wrong about other things on this car. This might not be any different. Now we're going to install this panel just to make sure everything's going to fit like it's supposed to. Now these panels are supposed to sit just a little bit off of the fender here, or off of the B-pillar. There should be a little bit of a gap here when you set everything up. And now we can continue with our seatbelt. Now the way we're setting this up is we're going to actually put this brace piece, the longer section of it, on the floor and the shorter section for the vertical part for the belt. And in doing that, it's going to give us a little more play off the back of this, but also keep us on the thicker metal of that torque box for the bolt. Just find the bolts. All right, we found our bolts, and we're going to show you something here on the inside of the car for the moment. This plate actually goes on the underside of the car. And this bolt, a grade 8 fastener and a fine thread, goes inside the car, and you can either put it with the bolt side up or the nut side up. It doesn't really matter how you do that. But what we'll say is, because the way this is working out in this particular application, you would do better to take the one going through the floor and install it with the bolt head up inside the chassis and the nut on the bottom side of the chassis. And it'll go through this plate assembly. All right, we've got our drill motor and we've got some tape. What we're going to do is we're going to size this to the almost exact size of this hole. You want a good tight fit on this. You don't want any slip, because that's bad news for you if the seat belts start moving forward in the hole. We kind of learned our lesson on the upper ones where we went too far with it, so we're taping this. Tape is just a guide. It's not going to stop that drill bit from going through. So you still have to keep your P's and Q's minded, but it'll let you know. You take your awl and set the center. Well, you know, it worked tonight. Now what we want to do, so that we don't damage this panel, is we're going to remove it, take it back out of the car temporarily. Kind of goes along with the whole idea of redo and undo and redo and undo ad nauseum. Now we've got more access room for our drill bit. Now, that'll go on the underside of the car, and your plate will go on top. Bolt will go through the center. This plate goes underneath. So far, that's it. All right, we grabbed ourselves a coarse thread bolt and a non-locking nut. And what we're going to use this for is to basically just set everything up just to see how it fits. So far, everything looks good. The hole that we bored in the top hasn't hurt anything. Everything's ready to go. So we're going to basically just do a check fit. Yep, there you go. That's basically how this bolts in. Now, we've got it bolted on this side. We can use this as actually some sort of a shim, if you will, so that when we set this up, if we need to move our bracket assembly here out a little bit to match with our cover, we can move it out here and pick up about a quarter, well, not a quarter, probably about an eighth of an inch. So, you know, this is just basically a check fit to see if we're where we need to be. All we gotta do now is put the panel back in, build our cover set up, good to go. Now, that finished up, what we've done is we've gone in and mounted all these things and put this back in. You'll notice that the trim panel is now sitting where it's supposed to, and I can only get about a fingernail's width between there, and that's normal. That's how that should be. What we need to do now, though, is to do a little more test fitting, because we may still have to go in and make some modifications to this part. And what we're going to do is we're going to stick these pieces up through here. Check fit. Looks like we're probably going to have to do a little bit of trimming work along the back edge here, but overall it fits pretty nice. And the seatbelt operates normally, so we're good to go. And that's really it. That's what it takes to get one of these seatbelt systems in a 67 Mustang Fastback. 68 would be a lot easier. Anything beyond 68 would be a lot easier. This, however, is a little more complicated only because of the fact of having to modify that upper section up here. Other than that, it's a pretty easy process. So, there you go. All right, now seat belts are done. We really like these, man. They're super easy to install, and the system works really nice. Now, about next week, we're going to be giving you some footage on...
Hey man, how's it going?
It's going good. Where have you been?
Been out of town.
Where?
Can't say.
You can't say. Alright, in any case, we're going to be giving you some footage on the stuff that we shot at SEMA. Now, we're going to SEMA next week.
We're going to SEMA? Really?
Where were you at for the meetings?
What meetings? When did we start having meetings?
The last time we all sat down, we decided to go to SEMA.
Huh?
You don't cool. remember? In any case, next week you'll be seeing the stuff that we find interesting at SEMA. That is, if some of us have enough brains to get on the airplane after being God only knows where. See you guys next week. Have a good one.
What?
There's a problem with my face, or maybe it's a problem with something in the way of the camera. No, there I am. There I'm not. Okay.